Hi all, welcome to UNSW in the Spotlight. My name is Brian, and I'm a commerce student here at UNSW Business School. Alongside that, I'm also one of the co-presidents at UNSW Business Society. Today, I'm joined by Associate Professor Christine Matthies.
Hi, Brian. Thanks so much for having me, and hello, everyone.
And we're going to tell you all about the Bachelor of Commerce and the Bachelor of BCom International. So, Christine, what do students study at the Bachelor of Commerce at UNSW?
Very good question, Brian. Students start off learning about business across all the different disciplines that make up the field of study of business. And they do that in an integrated first year. So they learn the generic knowledge and business skills that all business professionals require. That's then their launching pad to specialise in their second and third year of study. So all of our students complete at least one major. Most of them actually choose to complete two majors. What they will also do is actually start building their employability through a number of elements in the degree. So the My BCom is a fantastic series that weaves throughout the degree and combines both classroom learning and co-curricular activities so that our students can develop their professional skills. We also have work integrated learning in the second, third year of the degree. And then to cap off the degree, students complete a final year synthesis, which brings them out of their disciplinary specializations and transitions them into graduate employment.
That's brilliant. And how is the Bachelor of Commerce different from the Bachelor of Commerce International?
The Bachelor of Commerce International at its core has the Bachelor of Commerce, but of course it's got one extra year. So the BCom is a three-year degree, the Bachelor of Commerce International a four-year degree. And there's lots of really exciting things that happen in that extra year. So for example, students in the BCom International complete international studies at the Faculty of Art, Design and Architecture. So for example, they might study a language, global studies, international relations and so forth. And many of them actually use the opportunity to build that up to a third major. And then, of course, students have a 12-month exchange, overseas exchange. And because the BCom International is one of our most prestigious and most difficult to get into degrees, there's a whole bunch of really exciting co-curricular activities that are unique to the Bachelor of Commerce International. One example would be our Alumni Leaders Mentoring Program, which is where pretty much the executive suite of our alumni mentor the BCom International students.
And can students still get international experience in the Bachelor of Commerce program if they don't do the BCom International?
Absolutely, Brian. We want all of our students to get international experience. All of our business school degrees allow students to go on exchange, and that exchange can be one, two, or three terms. If full exchange is a little bit too much, there's also shorter study options. There's international short courses. And of course, there's our very popular global business practicums, which is a work integrated learning course that is completed working for a company overseas.
Now, Christine, what's the difference between a Bachelor of Commerce and a Bachelor of Business?
You've got really good questions today, Brian. So that really depends on the university. Sometimes the difference is only in the name. So for example, the University of Technology Sydney calls it a Bachelor of Business. University of Sydney and UNSW call it a Bachelor of Commerce. All of them are holistic business degrees. But some universities actually offer both a Bachelor of Commerce and a Bachelor of Business. And where that is the case, you will find that commerce is often the label that is used for the sort of more quantitative and analytics heavy side of business. So think in terms of finance, analytics, accounting, and the Bachelor of Business at those universities is used more for the ideas and people side of business. So think in terms of innovation, entrepreneurship, management, marketing, and so forth. At UNSW, we believe that an undergraduate business degree has to be holistic, and we just happen to use the term commerce that spans all of those disciplines.
And what makes the Bachelor of Commerce at UNSW different to other Bachelor of Commerce degrees?
I would say the most important difference is our people. You are a perfect example, Brian. We have the most amazing, keen, intelligent, and fiercely enthusiastic student cohort. And they're taught by equally enthusiastic and world-class staff. So it's really an environment where the best learn with and from the best, and I think that that's what makes us really special. But in terms of the curriculum, of course, there's also some key differences to Bachelor of Commerce degrees at other universities. For example, if I can single out the integrated first year that we have in the Bachelor of Commerce, that is actually the first degree globally that takes a holistic transdisciplinary approach to introducing students to business as a field of study, and takes an active problem-based learning approach to looking at these business problems, themes and opportunities. Another really big difference is the commitment and the integration on co-curricular learning. So it's not something that students do on the side, but the classroom learning and the co-curricular learning is embedded and integrated throughout, because we believe that an undergraduate degree is a really unique opportunity to start developing those generic business skills that will serve our students as graduates throughout their career.
And Christine, what sort of jobs do we see our graduates go into?
That completely depends on what a student makes out of their Bachelor of Commerce. I think one of the most exciting features of the degree is that it's incredibly flexible. It can be combined with a whole raft of degrees in double degrees. And it's really a case of students designing their own adventure with their very own Bachelor of Commerce. And that's why the career paths are just as diverse as how students kind of stitch their degree together. So of course we find our graduates in the Big Four consulting, accounting, banking firms and so forth. We also have plenty of students that become entrepreneurs, that work anywhere from small startups to government organizations to large multinationals and everything in between. So it's always fascinating to talk to our graduates and learn just how varied their careers actually are.
Awesome. Now, Christine, I think you have some questions for me.
Yes, absolutely. I'm glad it's my turn now. Brian, if I had to ask you in three words, how would you describe your UNSW Bachelor of Commerce experience?
In three words, I would say it's a window of opportunity, community and diversity.
And what's been the highlight so far for you at your time at UNSW?
So the highlight of my time has definitely been the journey I've been able to take with the Business Society, meeting some really awesome people and being able to experience a lot of things like snow trips, luncheons, and even going to lectures with those wonderful people.
Beautiful. Now, if you can only eat one type of food from UNSW for the rest of your life, what would it be?
Oh, that's a tough one, but I'll have to say a Yellow Eats rice bowl. Any combo of garlic, hummus, and aioli, especially for $12, it really is unmatched anywhere in the world.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with that, can you? What job title do you want to have in 5 years' time?
Look, I'm still a little torn, but if in 5 years' time I would be able to call myself a quantitative analyst or even a tech strategy consultant, I'll be a very happy man.
Excellent. I'll keep looking at your LinkedIn profile. Now, what is your one piece of advice for future commerce students?
My piece of advice would be to be afraid of new things and try them anyway. Uni really is a wonderful time. It's the perfect time to really try new things and meet some wonderful new people that you've never met before. What do you think, Christine?
Actually, very similar. You said before opportunities. So I would say there's so many opportunities. Make the best use of them and don't forget to have fun, because being an undergraduate student is just a really special phase in our lives.
Awesome. Well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you, Christine, for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Brian.
And if you have any questions about studying at UNSW Business School, be sure to reach out to a student advisor.